Good morning, children. Nice to meet you all once again through this English class. Today we are going to take the supplementary readers after 20 years. That is the story. In the first unit you have prose poem, and now the last one is the supplementary reader. The story name is After 20 Years. Before going to the story, and I wanted to tell you some hard words meaning. You turn to page number 31 in your textbook. Glossary is given there, page number 31. Avenue. Avenue means a wide street. That is a street which is not narrow, but it is a wide street. So avenue meaning it is a wide street. Then habitual. Habitual means regularly whatever you are doing. That is habitual. Nine. Nine means almost everything, like that we used to say, no, almost that also, almost this also, like that. So nine means almost. Then twirling. Twirling is twisting and spinning around. That is, you can, if you take one pencil, you can twist it or you can turn around it. That is called as twirling. Then intricate. Intricate is complicated. So any matter which is very complicated means a problem also. It is complicated means it is difficult to solve. No. So we say it is complicated. So intricate means complicated. Then stalwart. Stalwart means a man who is physically strong. Nice physical body, head, hands, legs, everything is strong. So that is called as stalwart. Swagger. Swagger means you walk in a confident way. A confident walk. That is called as swagger. Then vicinity. The surrounding area, or we call it as neighborhood. Vicinity means a surrounding area. Reassuringly. Making someone feel less doubtful. That is, they will not have any doubt. If you say to somebody, definitely I will do it, means so the other person will not have any doubt on you. So that is called as reassuringly. Then proposition. Proposition means a system, a order which you are following, a theory. Okay, you have to stick up to the order. Then plodder. One who toils slowly but steadily. One who works, who hard works. That is, toil means hard works. Plodder. One who toils slowly but steadily. One who works very hard, but it is a slow process, but it is a steady one. Okay, next one is wits. Wits means intelligent people, brilliant people, extraordinary people. Then groove. A dull routine that does not change. You also have a groove thing, you know, when you come to school. Every day you have to come to school, you have to study your lessons, again evening you have to go back, again you have to go to tuitions, then sleep, again early morning. That is called as a dull routine that does not change. Okay, next one is razor edge. It is a critical situation when you face some problems, no, you say, I'm in a critical situation, like that used to tell. So that is called as razor edge. Dismally, without happiness and cheer. You are not happy when you are sad. When something is pondering in your heart, you feel dismally. That is no happiness. Absurdity. Quality of being silly and foolish. When you say, somebody will say you are so foolish, no? That we call it as absurdity. Then egotism, a feeling of self-importance. You have that ego, no? I am a big shot. I am somebody. I am nobody. Like that, you used to have that feeling. That is called as egotism. Outline, you are describing something. Wires, it is sense a telegraphic message. So these are the black italic words which is given in your story, and you should know the meaning of it thoroughly. After that only when you read the story you can understand clearly. So now I'm going to the story. The author of the story is Henry. Oh, Henry. This man was born in 1862 and he passed away in 1910, and this man is a popular American short story writer. So he was original name, that man's original name is called as William Sidney Porter. His original name is William Sidney Porter. Then he, that is, his works, what he writes in his story, you know, romanticized the life of ordinary people in New York. So in New York City, where the ordinary people are there, middle class people are there, somewhat little bit well-to-do, I should say. So he portrays that type of people. people only in stories. It is stories are well known throughout the world. They express the effect of coincidence on characters and often had unexpected twist in the end. So stories sometimes it will be with it as a twist also. So stories are also noted for its witticism and clever wordplay. So O. Henry's prolific writing period, no, he started writing in the period 1902 in New York, and he wrote 381 short stories, and he wrote also one story a week for the New York World Sunday magazine for over a year. So this O. Henry's short story after 20 years was published on the Sunday edition of the New York World in 1905. The story also included in 1906 some anthology, the 4 million, and it has been republished in many short stories. Okay, so another many stories he also written, this Henry, and important ones are The Gift of the Maggie, The Coop and the Anthem, The Ransom of Sea Chief, A Retrievite Information, and The Third Ingredient. So these are the stories which he has written. This is about the author of this supplementary reader. Now I'm going to the story. So the story is very, very interesting. So after 20 years, you turn to page number 27, no? So you have to see some questions and activities are given in page number 27. I wanted to see that activities. So friends, first one is, what do you expect your close friends to do for you? Beautify the petals with your thoughts. So you have to beautify the petals with your thoughts. So what all thoughts you are putting, let us see. Friends you have to put in the middle, no? So friends, they comfort us. Okay, let us write that, comfort. Okay, next one is, some friends, no, they criticize us. When we do something wrong, no, they start criticizing us. So let us write criticize. Then some friends, no, they'll be going on listening, whatever you tell means they'll be going on listening. Some friends, no, when we have difficulties, they'll support us. Okay, so some friends will support us and also they help us physically, materially, with money, all that they do. Okay, so they take care of us. Friends, no, they take care of us. Where are you? What are you doing? Did you eat? Like that, all they used to take care of us. And also, we can share with our friends. So these are the things which you can. So beautify the petals with your thoughts. So I have to, I have given you so many words that describes about the friends in one word. That is one word already the author has given us, entertain. The friends will entertain us, no? Some they will tell us some jokes. Some they will sing songs. They entertain us. Then comfort. Then they criticize. They listen. They support. They help. They care. They share. Okay, so these are the things which about the friendship we can see. So that because the story is completely based upon the friendship. Next one, find out when the International Day of Friendship is celebrated. So International Day of Friendship is celebrated in the United Nations, okay, and it promotes the role and friendship play in promoting peace in many cultures. So the day which it is observed on July 30th. International year, every year. Okay, July 30th, every year. How is that day celebrated? Second one is, see, how is that day celebrated? The friends, know, they exchange flowers, cards, and also their tie wristbands is a popular tradition of these occasions. So friendship bands are very popular in India. They used to tie some type of colored ropes on our hands, friendship. So that is practiced in North India, okay? So that you can, that you use it for Friendship Day, okay? Then next we see, we have heard of the proverb, familiarity breeds contempt. Do you think that the passage of time strengthens friendship? Share your visions with your classes. So you can share it whatever you wanted to say because the passage of time strengthens our friendship. Spending time with our friends is the first step. It can build our stronger relationship. And I've already told you in the beginning, they help, they share. All that you can bring it here, okay, on your own. You can share
share it with your class friends. Okay, so now I'm going to go to the story. So what is the story about? The story, there are some two characters are coming, and that is the Jimmy Wells, a petrol man, and Silky Bob, and also a plain clothes man or the tall man. So three characters are coming in this story: Jimmy Wells, a petrol man, then Silky Bob, then plain clothes man or the tall man. So these are the thing, that is three characters is coming in this story. When it may take a long time, suppose if I read it, I tell you the story in the short form. So please listen to me, because hard words I have told you the meanings, and what is coming in the beginning, the activity also I shared with you, and now I'm going to the story. You please listen to the story carefully. So this story, the theme of the story is focuses on the reunion of two old friends. So the two old friends are Jimmy and Bob. Through their brief encounter, the two explore the themes of friendship, loyalty and trust. So characters in the story, already I told you, Jimmy Wells, a petrol man, Silky Bob, and the plain clothes man or the tall man. So what happens now, how the two friends are going to meet, we are going to see. So the policeman on the, when you turn to page number 27, I'll go very fast. The policeman on the beat move up the avenue impressively. Move up the avenue, I told you. What is the meaning of avenue? I told you, you should look to it. That is a wide street. Then the impressiveness was habitual. It is a regular and not for show, for spectators, for few. The time was barely 10 o'clock at night, but chilly gust of wind with a taste of rain in them had well nigh deep. Peopled the street. That is, the policeman was in the wide street and he was in the regular rounds, and the night was so chilly and no people were on the street, so it was little bit dark also. Trying doors as he went, twirling his club with many intricate and artful movements, turning now and then to cast his watchful eye adorn the pacific thoroughfare, the officer with his stalwart form. So this policeman, he was doing the patrol work. He was seeing each and every corner and nook and the places, if anybody is coming or going, all that he was seeing. And he was twisting his rod, what is having the police stick is having in his hand, and he was having a thorough guard over there. So he was having a slightly swagger. Means I already told you, swagger means a confident walk he's having in that vicinity area. His vicinity area means that is the neighborhood. When about midway of a certain block, a policeman suddenly slowed his walk. So in the street he was walking, then he slowed down his walk in the doorstep of a darkened hardware store. A man leaned with an unlighted cigar in his mouth. As the policeman walked up to him, the man spoke up quickly. So the man was having cigar in his mouth, the cigarette. So he was walking there in that place where the policeman is doing the patrol work. So that man was having cigar in his mouth and is walking towards the policeman. The policeman also is walking. "It's all right, officer," he said reassuringly. "I am just waiting for a friend." So this man, the man who has come there, is telling the policeman, "Sir, I have come here. I am just waiting for my friend, because 20 years back we have been, both of us made a promise that after 20 years we will meet in the same spot." That is, one of his friend was 18 years and he was 20 years. So these two friends, after 20 years, they made an assurance that they will meet in that same spot. So this man who has come with a cigarette in his mouth, no, he was come and waiting there. So he was telling to his the policeman, he was telling to the policeman, "In this place there was one big Joe Prady's restaurant." So the policeman said, "That restaurant is not now, it was taken away, it was dismantled 5 years ago." So, and the policeman was just talking to the man in the doorway, struck a match and lit his cigarette. The light showed a pale square jawed face with keen
keen eyebrow, with keen eyes and a white scar near his eye, right eyebrow. So this was the description given about that man who is talking to that policeman. Then he had a scarf pin, he had it with a large diamond only set. Then 20 years ago tonight, said the man, I dined here at Big Joe Praddy's, Jimmy's Well, at my best chance. So he was telling to that policeman, here only in this Joe Praddy's restaurant only I and my friend was having a night dinner, and we were just like brothers, and I was 18 and Jimmy was 20. The next morning I was to start with the best. So the next morning, this is 20 years back story, this fellow is narrating to the policeman that he went to the best to earn his money, to earn his bread, and this man Jimmy went to New York, thought it was the only place on the earth. Then well, we agreed that night that we would meet here again exactly after 20 years, day and night, no matter what was on the conditions might be, we might have to come here. We figured it in 20 years, each of us owed to the our destiny worked out, and fortune made whatever we are going there. So it was a very thing, and 20 years we spent our life, and this way after 20 years only I just want, I remember this day, and I wanted to meet my friend. So I came here. So this was the thing he was telling to that policeman. He said he, my friend will be coming exactly at 10 o'clock, and this man was praising his friend. His friend name is Jimmy, and this man who was having cigarette in his mouth, that name, that man's name was Bob. So don't forget, Jimmy was that man, a friend, and Bob was the other man, Silky Bob we call it. So and the man said, so it, I think it is 3 minutes to 10 o'clock, I think my friend will definitely come, and he will not that is, he will not disappoint me, so definitely he'll be coming. So as they were talking, it was a cold night and it was a little drizzling, and all thing was going, and this policeman was noting each and everything of this his friend. That is, the policeman name is, now I'm going to tell you, it is Jimmy. The other man who was standing is Bob. So they were not able to identify, but the Jimmy, the policeman, easily identified Bob. So he didn't exhibit, that is, he didn't tell him that his friend is, that is, he is Jimmy. He just kept quiet and he was talking to Bob. And the suspense I'll tell you in the end. So as he was talking and he was explaining, so it was now 3 minutes to 10 o'clock. He said, definitely this man told to the policeman, I will wait for 20 minutes more, after that and I will go, definitely my friend will be coming. So he was waiting, and suddenly the policeman said, I have to leave, my time is over, and that is, I have to leave the place. So he left. And as he left, another man came. That man was very tall, and he was talking to this man. This man, no, already I have described to you, he was having a square jawed face, keen eyes, right boy, that is a white scar in his right eyebrow, and he has a scarf pin with a large diamond, or also a diamond watch he was wearing. All this was the description about that man, Silky Bob. Okay, this tall man came, another man, the policeman left, the tall man came, and he was talking to him, and this tall man recognized this man who was in a diamond watch, this and that, and as they were talking, when the tall man appeared there to the scene, when the policeman left, this Bob, Silky Bob, he thought the tall man was his friend Jimmy, because the Silky Bob, he cannot recognize Jimmy. So he thought that is a new man who appeared over there, that is Jimmy. And he said, hello Jimmy, how are you, like that. Both were shaking hands, both were talking. And this Silky Bob, he had a little bit doubt in his thing, a mind, that this was not his friend, because as he was pausing, he was seeing his face, his appearance and everything. And he said, this was not Jimmy. Then finally, at one corner of of a drugstore. There was a drugstore. So I wanted to see you in a light. So there was a drugstore. There they went, where the electric lights were. When they came into that glare, each other, they turned simultaneously to gaze upon the other's face. The man from the west stopped suddenly and released his arm. What happened? "You are not Jimmy Wells," he snapped. So 20 years long, but not enough to change a man's nose from a Roman to a pug. So within a year, you cannot change the nose, because my Jimmy's nose is not like that. He is the different one. Before that, this man was not able to escape. This tall man who just was talking to this Silky Bob arrested him. And I tell you why he has arrested him. This Silky Bob, he was a criminal. Okay, so as he left 20 years back in the West, he started breaking the laws and he became a criminal. Okay, so this Chicago police, that is New York City police, was in the search of this Bob, Silky Bob. This is the man who is doing all sorts of criminal works. When Jimmy that day night, when he came to see his friend, no, he recognized that this was a criminal. Bob turned to be a criminal. So he don't want to arrest him. So he don't like to do that work. So he left the place quietly with a note to the tall man. So that note, a note that was given, that is, the tall man arrested that Bob, and he handed over a note to Bob. With that note, "Bob, I was at the point, place, on time. When you stuck the match to lit your cigarette, I saw it was the face of the man wanted in Chicago. Somehow I couldn't do it myself, so I went around and got the plainclothes man to do the job." So the Jimmy easily recognized Bob, so he don't wanted to arrest him, because after 20 years is going to meet his friend, so you don't want to arrest his friend. Out of friendship, out of love, out of compassion, he left that thing, and he made the other man to arrest it, because he was loyal to his job. So this is the friendship thing. So the Bob was arrested finally, and he received the note from Jim. So this was how they reunion. They were talking to them, but they were not able to realize. So 20 years later, one friend has become a truthful and honest worker, and one friend has turned to a criminal. Okay, so this is the union of the two friends. That's all the story, and I told you the theme is focuses on the union of two friends only. Okay, the friendship. So after that, you can see your textbook. You are turning your textbook, and textbook you have question answers that I will send it to you immediately. If you turn to page number 31, state whether the following statements are true or false. First one, meanings are given. Then you have the question answers. Question answers, I just make a click and I'll send you. And now you go to our textbook and write down which one is true and which one is false. The cop suddenly slowed his walks when he heard the barking of dogs. There was no dogs when you read that story. Okay, it is false. The friends grew up together, city of New York. No, both, yes, both were growing up when they were young stage. They both were grown up in the city of New York. That is true. So first one is false, second one is true. That both Jimmy and Bob were all of the same age. No, Bob was 18 and Jimmy was 20. So that was the age of the friends. So that is also false. The friends parted one night after watching a movie together. No, it is not like that. Both of them had a night dinner only and they parted. That is also Joe Prady's restaurant. The friends could not keep in touch because they lost each other's phone numbers. No, they had in touch only last 2 years only. They were not in touch with each other. So that is also a false. Okay. Then Bob wanted to stay for an hour more than the appointed time. Yes, that is true. He said, "I will wait for more than 20 minutes," like that he was telling. So Jimmy grew a little taller after he was 20. No. Jimmy was as he was when it false. So Bob realized that the tall man was not Jimmy Wells from the shape of his nose. Yes, from the shape of his nose that Bob was able to recognize it is not Jimmy Wells. So it is true.
Then, what does each of the following mean in the story? Choose the right option. On the beat. On the beat means on duty, walking around the assigned area. That is the answer. Okay, on the beat, on duty, walking around the right answer. Assigned area, you please tick it. A guardian of peace means that is the policeman. Okay, guardian of peace is policeman. Arm in arm means both of their arms were linked together. That is called with arms linked up together. Then plain clothes means a policeman in civilian clothes while on the duty. So plain clothes in mufti we call it, no, in our language, in our thing. That is a mufti has come the policeman. Okay, that plain clothes. Then answer the following questions in 3 or 4 sentences each. That is also a given there. I'll give it to you. I'll send it to you immediately. So please, children, study your portions. Don't waste your time. Very shortly we'll meet each other. Okay. So please study the lessons, and I will go to the unit 2 tomorrow itself. Thank you so much.